Welcome to Green Shine Farmers video blog about a family starting a farm and going back to the homestead lifestyle.
Hey guys, today we're going to talk about how to market and sell your produce. Now, if you're just starting out, selling your produce is kind of an intimidating thing. I mean, you know you can grow it, but can you sell it? And that's the big question. And I think that's what intimidates most new farmers when starting out. And so we're going to break down different strategies that you can use to market and sell your produce. We're going to talk about packaging. We're going to talk about labels. We're going to go into setting your prices. We're also going to talk about things like email marketing, putting out an availability list, and also how best to approach chefs and produce managers. So there's a lot in this one. Hope you guys enjoy. Let's get into it. Now first, a little backstory. We moved down here around 3 years ago, and before we even moved here, we had heard that the farmer scene is really saturated. We heard, you know, there's a ton of farmers, and Asheville's kind of a small city. It's only around 85,000, and even though people here are really into local, we knew it was going to be competitive. We knew we had to find a way to kind of differentiate ourselves. So one of the first things we did when we got down here is we started microgreens. Now, if you haven't seen our microgreen video yet, I'll put a link in the description. We've got two different ones, how to do them outdoor, how to do them indoor. And microgreens are great because within 2 weeks, we had a crop that we could then take to produce managers and various chefs and show them what we were growing and kind of get our foot in the door. And so that was our strategy. But I think what really set us apart from anyone else is our packaging. So that's what I want to dive into right here. You know, packaging is very important. There's a reason that the iPhone comes in a nice heavy case and gives this appearance of being a really high value item. Now, you don't need to go to quite the extent for your produce, but you want it to be presentable and you want it to stand out, especially if you're selling to grocery stores. So what we have found is that these little clamshells work really well for that purpose. Now, I know I'm gonna get a lot of comments on using plastic, and personally, I don't like it either. So if anybody knows an alternative to plastic, you know, something that would also be food grade that we could use instead of this, I would love to hear about it, because these aren't cheap. That's the one downside to packaging is, you know, I think for our 5 ounce containers, this is what we do our 5 ounce salad mix in, these are about, 66 cents a piece, and they've only gotten more expensive with all the trade wars and everything. So when it comes to packaging your produce, here's what we do. We will use I believe this is a 32 ounce container for our microgreens, and this holds about 3 ounces of pea shoots or micro radish or sunflower, stuff like that. And then for our salad mix, we use a 64 ounce clamshell. Now, you can find these at Webstron. I'll put links for that as well. But like I said, I really want to find an alternative to plastic, maybe something that's derived from corn or something like that instead. Because that's the one downside to this packaging. Now, for chefs, we're going to use 1 pound bags for all of our salad mix, and we'll use maybe a smaller 12 ounce bag for things like microgreens. Now, another thing that I'd really like to talk about is labels. You could go in there with kind of just any sticker, and that's fine, but you know, for not very much money, you could get a Brother QL800 printer. Again, I'll put links for all this stuff in the show notes. And for that, you could create your own label, and it's actually very economical. I mean, to create labels like this, you're talking about maybe a penny per label, and you can change it up very easily. It's a simple editing program, and you never need to buy ink. The ink is actually contained within the label itself, and the laser kind of just brings it out. So a great option. It's only about $80 or so on Amazon, and I would highly recommend going in there with a professional package, because that tells the produce managers and the chefs that you're serious about your product, that you take quality very seriously, and that can only look good for you. One more thing I should add, for all of our bags, to seal them, we use this bag sealer. Again, you can get it on Amazon, and this is just much quicker than twist ties. When we first started out, we were twist tying each bag, and it took forever. For this, it's very simple to just twist your bag and seal it.
Okay, now the question becomes, how much should you charge for your produce? Now, setting your prices is tricky because it's going to depend on your location, and it's going to depend on your customers. Obviously, if you're selling to grocery stores, you're going to have to sell it for a bit less than you would selling to a high-end restaurant, just because their margins are a lot tighter. You know, grocery stores are typically looking to make around 40 to 50% on all the produce they buy, because they have to count for spoilage and things not, you know, getting sold before they go bad. And so for us, you know, it's gonna depend on your location and your market. If you're in New York City, you can probably get a lot more than if you're in rural Idaho. So you've got to set your numbers according to your market. But one good thing to keep in mind, and just to kind of get a baseline of where things are at, is I would go to your farmer's market and kind of walk around and see what other people are charging for their produce. To give you an instance of what we charge here is, you know, to grocery stores for things like salad mix and those 5 ounce containers, we'll typically do those for $3 a piece, and they'll retail them for maybe anywhere between $3.99 and $4.99, depending on the store. Now, for something like microgreens, we'll do a 3 ounce container for, again, about $3 a piece, and they'll mark it up about the same. Now, for restaurants, you can charge a little bit more depending on what it is, the time of year, and so on and so forth. So for restaurants, for our salad mix and greens, we'll probably do that around $8 to $10 a pound, depending on the season. And for microgreens, we're typically at around $15 to $20 a pound for something like sunflowers and pea shoots. Something that's a little daintier, like micro arugula, however, we're doing it around $4 an ounce. And again, you're just gonna have to feel out your particular situation and just be honest. I mean, ask these chefs, ask these produce managers, you know, how are my prices? And they'll tell you. They'll tell you straight up, it's a little bit much, or, you know, I think this is competitive. And so the best way to find out is just to get out there and talk to people. Okay, the next thing I wanna talk about is your approach. So when you walk in there, you wanna be dressed respectably. You don't need to wear a suit and tie, you know, dress like a farmer, but make sure there's not mud on your boots. I definitely made that mistake early on and was looking down at my feet and I just had this little mud pile that I left on their floor, and I, you know, needless to say, I didn't get a call back. So, you know, make sure you've got clean shoes on and just dress respectable. Jeans and a flannel work. You're a farmer, so dress the part, you know? And when you go in, you know, go in high energy. You don't need to be over the top, but just be down to earth. Have a smile on your face, have enthusiasm in your voice, be excited about what you're doing. You know, when they see that you're excited and you're enthusiastic about what you're doing, it kind of just gives the impression that, you know what, this person's stuff is probably gonna be really good. I mean, look how excited they are, look how passionate they are. And that resonates with people, you know? People feed off energy, so you need to go in and really believe in your product. I mean, I remember when I was younger, I had tried sales, you know, in my 20s, and I was just terrible at it. I hated it. It felt like I was trying to, you know, I felt like I was trying to fool people into buying from me. And so it just never felt really good to me. But, you know, honestly, over the years, I've learned that sales is really nothing more than just developing relationships with other people and finding a way to bring value to whatever they do. It's that simple. So now when I go in there, I know my product is really good. I know people love it. I know it has a great shelf life. I know that they're getting it within 48 hours of harvest, and I'm highlighting all those points, and I'm just saying, here you go. If it works for you, let me know. I'd love to do business. And just realize a lot of buyers are not gonna give you a decision on the spot. They like to think it over. You know, it takes some time. They wanna sometimes see if you're gonna come back and follow up with them. And I think it's maybe just a kind of a subconscious test to see how serious you are. You know, these chefs and these buyers, they get hit up all the time, and the people promise them the world, and then they never really come back around to follow up or anything. They just kind of disappear. So that's what I've heard from a lot of chefs. You wanna make sure that once you drop off your sample, you have a good conversation, and you say, hey, can I get your email so I can put you on our availability sheet? 99% of them are gonna say, yeah, here you go, here's my email. And that leads us to our next topic, which is putting together an email marketing sheet, or, you know, kind of an availability sheet. Now for this, I like to use a platform called MailChimp. It's just a very easy to use, it's free, and it has kind of pre-made templates, so you can kind of just drag and drop your stuff in. There's a million different ones out there. MailChimp's probably the most popular. And so, you know, all you're really gonna do is you're gonna put in pictures of all your stuff and make sure they're nice pictures, because pictures really sell it. You know, so if you're gonna take a picture of beets, make sure they're clean. And if you sell them with the greens on, make sure to really, you know, feature that. Get a nice camera, you know, most iPhones will do, and just put good pictures together, give maybe a brief description, or just have your prices. Okay, now the three things you wanna have before you approach any potential buyers is a price sheet with all your items written on it, the prices, any potential price breaks for quantity, and all your contact information, and when those items will be available. The second thing is a business card, just something simple with your name, your email, just basic contact info. And the third thing is a sample. So make up, you know, if you're going to go out, just plan on making around 20 to 25 samples up. And you're going to have to hit up a bunch of different places. If the first person it doesn't seem interested, don't get discouraged. Just keep going. It's a numbers game. If you have a great product and you set your prices competitively, it's going to work for somebody. Somebody's going to say, hey, this guy has really good produce and these prices are fair. And I think this brings a lot of value to me. So it's an easy decision for them. But just understand that sales is a numbers game. If the first person is not interested, just keep going. And what you're going to find is a lot of times you might not get to the decision maker. You might get to a sous chef who doesn't really make the decisions and says he'll pass along your stuff. But a lot of times things get lost in the cooler. So, you know, but what you want to do is get as much information as you can, you know, get the chef's email, find out a good time to reach him, get as much info as you can, because that's going to come in handy later. A lot of places don't say yes on the first time. You have to go back and touch them and send them a follow-up email and keep reaching out until they just say no. I mean, and that's really what sales is. And so don't get discouraged if it doesn't happen right away. However, when you go in there with your sample, your business cards, your price sheet, be ready to take orders. You never know where the chef might say, hey, you know what? Yeah, bring me 10 pounds of salad mix next delivery date. So let them know when you deliver, and also when you set your delivery date, do it at a time that's convenient for them. Now for produce managers, that could kind of just be any time before 5. They're typically there all day. For chefs, they get really busy around lunch and then before dinner. So this ties into when best to approach these buyers. Produce managers, typically there all day. Chefs, you want to hit up probably between 10 a.m. and 11 a.m. And then they're going to get busy prepping for lunch. So you're going to want to then circle back around at around 2 to 4 p.m. And that's kind of after the lunch rush, but before the dinner rush. You do that, you're going to get a more receptive audience. If you catch a chef in peak of lunch, he's not going to want to talk to you. It's just they have so much going on that you really have to catch them on their downtime. And a lot of times you're showing up with a sample, price sheet, all that. They're going to be receptive.
I mean, I remember the first time I made up sample bags and went around to, restaurant to restaurant. We were living in Chicago at the time, and I probably hit up 20 different chefs that day. And out of 20 different chefs, I got one chef to say yes and place an order with me a week later. And that was a big deal, because to me that validated everything I was doing. And it was like, you know what? This is a great product, and people do want it. So anyway, don't get discouraged if it doesn't happen. If you kind of fall flat your first few times, just keep going at it. Eventually somebody will say yes, especially if you're going there with a great product and your prices are right. They really have no reason not to take your product. And so anyway, thank you guys for watching. I'll see y'all next time.
If you guys like this video and you'd like to see more like it, leave us a comment down below. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Also, visit us at greenshinefarms.com and follow us on Instagram at greenshinefarms. Thanks for watching. See you guys next time.